Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today I'm going to show you how to get better at FL Studio. So it sounds simple, and I'm going to show you guys the shortcuts. So this is over 10 years of teaching folks. If you don't know me, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. We train over a million producers around the world. Some are going to work with Drake, Kanye West, Post Malone, Ariana Grande, French Montana, Young Thug, Lil Baby, Trippie Redd, Polo G, J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar, a long list of folks. And basically, it comes down to these five buttons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you guys don't see those buttons, click it where it says View. Go to Arrange Windows and then click Realign. This will fix all your windows. So to get better at FL Studio, here's some settings I recommend. First, let's go to what's called the Channel Rack, which is this thing here. And we're going to right click and go to our piano roll here. We're going to right click on whatever sound you guys have. Go to the piano roll. So by default, FL Studio doesn't label notes. This will destroy you as a producer. Trying to learn how to click in notes, because when you learn piano, I'm learning shapes based on looking at the piano straight on, whereas you guys are looking at the notes sideways, and there's no way to really learn piano sideways. Okay, so let's go to the top left. Let's go to View, and we're going to go to where it says Key Labels. Turn on all notes. So if you turn this off, for example, here's what it looks like. It's impossible to write music this way. This is why it's so hard for people to learn music theory, because it's not labeling the notes. Okay, so usually it's on root notes, actually. So this is what it looks like by default. Very difficult for beginners. Again, when you produce music digitally, you have to see the notes, because we're producing horizontally, not vertically, like on a real piano. So we're going to click all notes here. That's going to save you guys a lot of headache. The next thing is we want to set a snap to grid. I would recommend keeping your snap to grid at 1/2 beat. This is something that it took me a long time to get used to, but in short, this is the easiest measurement I found. And if I have to go smaller, I'll go to 1/4 beat and get more granular. The issue is here that as a beginner producer, you might have your grid super microscopic, and then you're going to learn patterns and rhythms, and you're like, wait, I don't even know where the 1, 2, and 3 is, because there's so many vertical lines to measure. It's half impossible to like quickly look at stuff. So I'd recommend you guys keep this on 1/2 beat. Another thing is up top here, we're going to turn on the metronome. That will help you guys. Also, I keep my countdown before recording on, and I keep my blend recording on. And then I have what's called a typing keyboard to piano, so I could use my actual computer keyboard to play notes on the keyboard. If you right click here, you can select your root note. I keep mine on default, so if you ever have to reset, just click reset. So by default, it's at C4, and then it's on the layout piano. You can also set this to Slice X. So if you guys chop up drum breaks, you can play your Slice X through here, and also your FPC. People don't really know about that. So that is, as far as performance, those are the things people skip. Now let's talk about quality of sound, okay? I need you guys to hear this back to back so you understand the difference. Let's load up FL Keys, and we're also going to load up a plugin called Flex, which is like their newer kind of trying to get better sounds plugin. If you go to Get, go to Essential Pianos, and we're just going to load up like a Steinway, which is like a classic grand piano. Now, I'm going to use some shortcuts here. This is in FL Studio 2024. Let's right click, go to piano roll, and let's go in here. Now, another thing is I would recommend you guys keep your piano roll big. Okay, so if you are trying to produce and your piano roll is like this big, it's going to be really difficult to learn music when your piano roll is like that small. Okay, so make it as big as you can when you use the piano roll, in my opinion. So here, let's write out some notes. If in the newer version, FL 2024, hit Alt-P. This pulls up the chord progression tool. If you want to do it the old-fashioned way, go to your tools here, and then go to Generate Chord Progression, and it loads up the screen. And this is a new sequence, so this must be new for them. Okay, so what you do here is you right-click, you set your key. So let's say we're in the key of C-sharp, and then minor. We're going to do minor natural. I'm right-clicking on this so I could select multiple options. And then we're going to hit generate, and it will create chords in that scale. That's pretty cool. Okay, let's hit accept. Now, most people, again, I'm generalizing because we're speaking to a lot of folks. Most people don't write proper harmony. So using that chord progression tool will get you, again, 50% of the way as far as your composition. I've studied so much music production, I can tell you guys that when you guys want to make better melodies, it's because you're skipping over chords, and that's why you're getting stuck. So if you want to get better at FL Studio, try using harmony, a lot more harmony. I'm not telling you guys what to do creatively, but that's where a lot of people get stuck. So let's highlight these and hit Alt-G to ungroup those notes. Another thing is understanding voicing, but we don't want to get too deep into music theory today. But I just want to show you guys a couple things on voicing, for example. So simply pulling that down gave it a vibe. What if we take this middle note, the third, pull it up an octave? Now we have a pain loop. Let me pull this back up an octave, control up. Also, knowing the piano roll shortcuts, I have a whole video. If I remember, I'm probably going to forget though, because I do so many videos. If I remember, I'll leave a link below, but type in piano roll shortcuts, Busy Works Beats. A video will pop up and I go through all the shortcuts you guys need to know about FL Studio. Okay, so there's a lot of shortcuts. Knowing these shortcuts will save you so much time. Like I just did so many just now without even thinking. Like I highlighted hitting control. I hit control up to move the notes up or down an octave. You go down or up with control. Shift up and down moves them up one note at a time. You know, there's little things about the piano roll. So let's say my notes look like this. I can hit control L to make them longer. Control Q is quantized. You know, I'm just giving you guys a couple. You know, it's a whole video on this, but let's say you kind of are off the grid like this. I can hit control Q and it will quantize it to my snap to grid value in that case, which is one half step. And I can hit control L to elongate those notes. And understanding voicing too. Okay, now one thing I want you guys to understand too in FL Studio is sound quality with stock plugins. Now they have updated their FL Cloud, which is a paid program. And I would recommend you guys look at, let me open up my browser. If you go to your browser, for the longest time, I couldn't figure out how to get to the FL Studio Cloud. So go to your browser, click on where it says sounds, and this should load up the FL Cloud from what I remember. Okay, now look at the, I would recommend you guys look at their plugins. Anything from minimal audio, anything from UVI is really good. Okay, so UVI, minimal audio, really good. So get those plugins first. Because sound quality, you know, with the stock plugins, you guys are not going to get sound quality. I'm going to prove it to you. So here's the stock plugin, which is the higher quality plugin, okay, in FL Studio. Now, I know I'm kind of jumping all over the place, but if you guys want better stock sounds as far as like a DAW and you're on a Mac, I would highly recommend Logic Pro. FL Studio just does not have the proper stock sounds, okay? Logic Pro comes with the stock sounds. If you guys want to use only what's in the DAW, Logic Pro is the best stock sounds I've ever heard in a DAW. FL Studio has the best canvas and workflow, but it does not have the best stock sounds. They're working on it now, okay? But it's a paid program right now, so it's not coming with the DAW. Okay, so there's the piano. Now I'm going to play a grand piano from my keyboard that's not inside the DAW, just to show you guys the quality difference of sound. All right, now let's play my keyboard. It's just a higher quality. Okay, so if you don't know what a real piano sounds like, you're gonna always be like, why don't my beats sound like so-and-so? It's because so-and-so might be using real instruments and higher quality gear. Again, we can't expect a free DAW to give out everything for free. I just want you guys to understand that's why your beats aren't really getting to that next level, is because you're using stock sounds that just are not gonna sound ever like the real thing. It doesn't matter how much EQ, chorusing I add on here, how much reverb, it's not gonna sound like the real thing. Okay, so another thing is, so what I'm saying is when you go to mix, for example, you guys are like, okay, which plugins can make all my melodies sound better? But if your sound does not sound good to begin with, like I don't need to do anything to that piano. It already sounds amazing. So when you come with that mindset with producing, you will be better in FL Studio. But again, if you have to do 1,000 things to your sound to get it where you need to go, it's just not the right sound. Okay, now let's talk about audio. Let's grab some loops from Adu Sounds. He makes really, really fire loops. So one thing to get better at FL Studio is to understand measurement and time. Now, Adu Sounds does this really well where he labels the loops. So this number here, 114 BPM, represents this number here. So they need to match. Okay, so let's pull this down to 114 and let's just drag this in like so. Now, if we turn on the metronome, it should like lock in with the loop. Should match the timing. So another thing, area you guys need to improve is with audio. So let me show you how much you can do, because there's so much to teach you guys. I don't want to make this video like 2 hours long. I have a full video about FL Studio 21. Just type in FL Studio 21, everything you need to know, busyworksbeats.com, or, you know, busyworksbeats, and it will pull up the video. So you guys need to understand how to manipulate audio. So for example, FL Studio is a little bit different from Ableton. Ableton creates time warping and like all this stuff behind the scenes for audio to make audio really easy. FL has not updated that feature yet. Okay, so it's a lot of steps we have to do. Firstly, let's grab the slice tool. There's no one way to produce, but I like to sample in the playlist now as opposed to in the channel rack and in plugins like I used to. Now that I have this in here, you know, we need to know, okay, to separate this from the rest of the song, because still this is a part of the rest of the song. So the FL Studio is treating this still like the old song. We need to click in the top left, go to make unique as a sample, hit yes. So now this is its own loop. Okay, so it's not looking at the rest of the song. So now I could do stuff like reverse it by double clicking on the sample, hit reverse. So now the question becomes, how can I flip this without doing too much? So in the actual sampler, if you double click on the audio, it pulls up the sampler. You could do things like reverse. We could fade out, crossfade, trim the sample for any gaps in the audio, or for any, silence in the beginning or end of the audio. Okay, we can go to the pre-computed effects. Some people love the stereo delay effect. So basically it creates a left to right pan to make the sound a little bit wider. You could add reverb from within the sampler. Okay, if you want to push the sample back, there's Pogo, which is, I believe, a time manipulation to make stuff sound slower, faster. There's a cutoff filter right in the sampler. So again, people kind of overlook all this stuff. It's right here for you. I don't use ring modulation, but let's, I don't really use that at all. And then there's a boost for like 808s and stuff. You guys can boost your 808s. You can clip your 808s. So again, people don't really know about the stereo delay. So you could do a lot without adding plugins. And that's another thing about FL Studio that people get stuck on, is they don't know how to use the like computer functions before they're trying to run to a plugin, which is, again, I understand. It's a lot to learn. But also you guys can double click. You can right click. You can open this up in Fruity Slicer. Let's do the Wonder Girl technique. Let's slice this by the beat and we can pull up our attack. Now, most people would go out and buy like a glitch plugin, but all you have to do is just open it up in Slicer and then add this pattern to the playlist. We're going to mute the original. And that's how you get that Drake bounce, just like that. Turn it up a little bit. Just like that. We turned a simple loop into a Drake bounce, and it already sounds 90% of the way there. Now, other people would be loading up Gross Beat, trying to flip it through Glitch and doing all this other stuff, Shaper Box and stuff. And it's no shade to those plugins. It's just that we don't need that workflow. And another thing about FL, there's so much about FL Studio that, you're going to run into a lot of guys telling you there's only one way to do something. In FL Studio, there's like 10 ways to do the same thing. Okay, so there's no one perfect way. And that's the beauty of FL, is you could do the same thing 10 different ways. Now, another thing though, let's keep that rolling. Another thing you guys need to understand is that drum sounds need to hit right off the bat, unless you guys know how to mix. Like, your drum sound should already be where the sound is trying to go. If you have to like force your drums to sound a certain way, it's probably the wrong drum sample. Okay, so if you have to do too much to your drums, in hip hop at least, it's just not, you're using the wrong drums, okay? So I have a go-to drum kit. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. I compiled 8 of my favorite sounds. Oops, wrong pack. And a little laser. So I compiled 8 of those sounds out of 800 gigabytes of sounds that I have. I compiled 8 of my favorite sounds, and you guys get them for free. So that's my go-to kit. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. Okay? And you'll get that for free, along with a bunch of other stuff. So what I'm saying to you guys is like, drums should already hit. And I'm just throwing this beat together. We're not trying to make a smash hit right now. And I'm just showing you guys how easy it is once you have the right sounds. Again, this is a big thing that most beginners can't comprehend, because they just don't realize that they don't have the right sounds. Okay. And it took me years to realize this myself, is I was like, oh, I just don't have the right sounds. I'm using the wrong 808. I'm using the wrong kick. That's why it doesn't sound like so-and-so. I'm just literally using the wrong sample. Like, once you have the right sounds, that's how easy making a beat can be, if that's how you want the beats to sound. And now I can go to my keyboard and add like the quality sounds over this loop, just to show you guys like the final touch. So we gotta figure out the root note. So it's B flat. Alright, let's add a little piano over this. Again, I didn't anticipate making a beat, but. Simple as that. You add a realistic instrument over top, or your guys' touch, whatever that thing is for you. It could be a guitar over your mic, it could be your voice, and now we have a realistic beat that's pretty much done, if not already done. That's how simple making beats can be. It's just when you guys aren't doing it the right way, it becomes more complicated. Let me show you guys another. I don't want to make this video too long because there's so many gems to give you guys. I got to make sure I'm not like overdoing it. There is a suite of plugins called the Killer Hearts plugins. These are extremely good. So I'm going to use their pitch shifter. They have so many dope ones. I'm just going to use this one for now. But if you guys are going trap, look at Crystallizer from Soundtoys. That's a good one, but it's a paid plugin. But this one's free. It's called Pitch Shifter. We're going to pitch this up 12 semitones. It's going to pitch our piano up. And then we're going to blend the mix in. This is also good for like top line type melodies that are higher pitch. Another plugin. I'm making this video too long. I need to wrap it soon. Let's do some Fruity Wave Shaper here. Let's put it on 4x oversampling. Turn the mix up. Turn the pre up. Turn this knob like this. Run that through Fruity Soft Clipper. Just to show you guys, you don't need 1,000 plugins to make your beat sound good. Like, it's 2 plugins right here. I'm taking off the pitch shifter for now. People, they slam their 808 to disguise their bad mixing. So this is what some people, let me just show you guys what the pre-computed effects can do. So if you go to pre-computer for the 808, you can turn up the boost. I don't mess with the clipping because it squares off the sound. I don't like that sound. It looks like my camera froze. I don't know what happened there. Sorry about that. So let's turn up the boost. My camera just froze. Personally, I don't think the 808 needs to hit that hard. I think that's a little OD. But that's it, guys. It's not complicated. You have 4 sections. Here's my last point. You have 4 sections to a song. If you want to get better at FL, know these 4 layers. You have a rhythm section. You have a contrast section, which is usually bass. Okay, you have the top lines. And then you have something I call harmony. Now, in this case, this has harmony inside. So it's like top line slash harmony, which is your chords. Those 4 layers make a beat. I think people overcomplicate it because they don't know those 4 categories. Again, we didn't even make, like, that's how fast you can make a beat. And of course, we didn't go all the way in, but just wanted to show you guys how to get better at FL Studio. Sorry about the webcam just randomly just going off. I'll fix that in a second. But, to get these go-to sounds, go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio to learn more. I have a free FL Studio course on my website. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium, and you can sign up for free. All right, peace out, guys. Subscribe if you're new. Like the video. Share with a friend. Peace.